don't know me, which I'm pretty sure is everyone. I'm Daniel, and though I haven't known Hayden as long as some of the other people here, this young man is still one of my best friends. So I guess I'll go through this chronologically and nostalgically, as is tradition. I first really got to know Hayden in year 8 at CGS when we bonded over a purely academic love of Latin at Latin camp. We did have a prior encounter that I remembered clearly when he accosted me with a trilobite fossil.
Yes.
So I wasn't really sure what to make of things at first, but he performed
I had a little sound effect for it and everything.
Everyone meets. The rest of the trip was hallmarked by repetitive electronic music, crazy Korean chips, various outlandish Roman escapades, and I emerged with a new great friend. Hayden would continue to be one of my consistent friends I could always hang out with, regardless of the unpredictable ebb and flow of high school social circles. Hayden always struck me as someone very mature for his age, and yet maintained an unwavering and exuberant outlook on life. I always admired that in him. Though the two of us would often mingle in our free time, we actually had surprisingly few classes together, especially in later years. Despite our surprisingly few classes together, it so happened that our mutual love for Latin, which initially made us such good friends, would continue to serve our friendship in year 12, in both Latin and Latin extension, in which we were the only two enrolled. I really got to know Hayden even better in these classes, and it was only really here that I realised his overall vibrance and positivity never really turns off. We both have a lot of fond memories from that class, some that I will remember forever. If you ask him, I'm sure he'd be happy to share the recording with you if he hasn't already.
Absolutely.
When it came time for all of us to go our separate ways, it was worrying to consider that I might lose such an honest and fun friend to the sunny beaches of Queensland.
Mm-hmm.
But to his credit, he will always strive to keep in contact and catch up whenever he glimpses freedom among his bustling and impressive academic career. I can only hope that this doesn't change and that we are still in touch in the many years to come. Hayden. Everyone is here today because we want to celebrate what a unique, intelligent, and driven friend, or son, or nephew, that you have become in these 21 years. I hope you have a marvelous day next week and do a little bit better handling your first beer as a legal worldwide adult. And I just want to thank you for being one of the best friends imaginable, always cheering me up and having a great time together. I wish you all the best in your bright future. Happy 21st.
Such a good projecting voice, which is why I offered it to Lon. And not until I hear him speak that I realized, yes, he really did not need one. But I do. Well, I just like to thank you all for coming here to help us celebrate our son about to turn 21. Not quite ready to drink yet in America. Near enough. Hayden is a very ambitious and sentimental person. He wants to move ahead, but he also wants to stay back. And he cares a lot about his friends. When he knows that he's going to spend his 21st birthday in Queensland, it sort of tore him apart. He's going to miss some of his friends in Canberra. And so, which is why now we split the birthday celebration into the ACT and the Queensland. And we're going to do all this again in Queensland for his Queensland, new Queensland friends. He's always a loyal friend. He's a good son. And people ask me how are your kids. I say, oh, kids, we really haven't had too much trouble. You know, doesn't do drugs, doesn't smoke. Doesn't go out chasing chicks. Well, maybe that's, I don't know. and we communicate well, and he has always been a supportive and loyal son to the parents and friend to his friends and classmates, and we are proud to have you.
Talks of drugs and smoking, I would say there's no need for Hayden, you just need to give him some sugar. and then he becomes, like, so one thing that I really associate with Hayden is he is always a ball of energy. And having him around, it's, you can't stop. Brian and I, we would always look forward to coming down to Canberra when we were kids to hang out with Hayden and Jessica. These two, when they're together, are a destructive force. So you've got hurricanes, you've got tornadoes, and you've got these two. This guy is definitely a ball of energy. So I remember sleeping on that couch and then waking up, and his face is all I can see. So and I can't remember what it is, but like, let's go to Questacon. Hayden is a very resourceful man as well. For most of my life of knowing him, he's always had at least a belt of tools. Before even wearing 40s, he's managed to have a camera around his neck. he doesn't have that anymore. So he's a bit of a gadget man, and I like that about him. And I think he was the guy that introduced me to Star Wars. It's great to have Hayden in my life. And it's great to see that he's got such a wonderful bunch of friends from school, from uni, and I hope all the best for you and with all your future endeavors.
Thank you.
Now that Arthur's in sense of kind of like forced to say something too. Well, I've also known Hayden his entire life. I'm a month older, but I will always put it that I'm a year older. I'm a year older. This is December, January. But yeah, as Arthur said, like, we would destroy things. originally, I thought I wouldn't be able to say anything. It's just, I just know too much. Like, I can't say anything without completely incriminating him in front of, like, his family, his friends, but there's a lot of memories, one of them being just, as Arthur said, sugar. He wasn't very specific as to the sugar. So, this cake, you know, this, like, soft drinks, but when Arthur said sugar, he's actually like, you grab the sugar. You eat the sugar. You get the sugar and eat it. And I didn't do that. I went to the cafe and I was, you know, but then, like, it looked like fun. I had sugar, he had sugar. And then, no matter what, because as well as the Auntie Sherry always dresses up in the same clothes. So you couldn't tell who we were. And we were running around, and when we attack you, we're like, you know, twin ninjas, you know. And I remember this one time we were at, it was Kevin's 21st, and we were still actually quite old to be on sugar, like, and we were like, we were smashing things, like insects and like leaves, and like trying to like throw them on people's hair. And it was very mature. I know Sean said he's very, very mature. Depends how you define that, I guess. But other than that, everyone said he's like the most sentimental person. He's so sentimental that I remember he fell in love with the teddy bear named Katie. And he carried around with him everywhere. And it's kind of, he held everything to heart. And he's so sentimental. I'm so lucky to have him in my life. Pretty much the entirety of my life. I mean, like, 1 month, really. Like, last month. And I just wish he was in Sydney, but he's in Queensland. And it's very sad. But I will hopefully notice for the rest of my life knowing him, getting to know him better, and hopefully our kids don't have sugar. And I wish you all the best, and I'll see you next week.
Yes.
I didn't prepare anything.
Do you want
We can go through the photo album eventually. I didn't have anything prepared. I couldn't think of what I'm supposed to say at such a time like this, but you know, you guys have been bringing up how special you are to me, and it's very true that you are all very dear to me. And Dad mentioned the whole split between Queensland and Canberra thing, and that's very true in terms of when I did initially try to plan just one party in Brisbane and try to have everyone there, you know, there are all of these Queensland people that I know, all of these medical people and college people, but it really didn't feel right not having you guys, like my foundation, and that really tore me up, and like Dad said, and that was eating me up all the way up until I cancelled that event that I had done that, so, and thank God I got rid of that. But yeah, it just, like, as soon as I did that, I was like, none of you guys, none of the people who shaped me into who I am from where I started would have been there, and that just would have been wrong. So I'm really glad that I've been able to have you come tonight, and I'm extremely blessed to know all of you. and
group hug.
Yes, I have you been enjoying it?
Yeah.
I hope that I can keep in contact with you all for the rest of my life too. So.
I'm gonna pass in this embarrassing photograph.
Alright, let's eat some more dessert, watch some more.